Yesterday we finished up with the characters, general characters हमने बात करी, in general that of the thallophyta members. Further the classification is there, and what about the classification? Modes of reproduction में भी मैंने आपको बताया asexual, sexual है, spore formation से होता है, gamete formation से होता है, ठीक है, ये कल हमने discuss किया. Along with all those characters, there are some specialized characters that which provided the different classes of the division this thallophyta, ठीक है. The first is a class Chlorophyci. Chlorophyci, as the name is saying, this is having the chlorophyll in it. Chloro name it has got from the Chlorophyci. ठीक है, chlorophyll से इसको नाम मिला है. Chlorophyci, chloro term जो मिली है वो chlorophyll से मिली है. So having the presence of chlorophyll, these are green in color. So they are called as green algae. These are all green members of the thallophyta, so they are called as a green algae. Now, what are the pigments present in it? I already told you that is this is the first feature. What are the pigments? हमने बोला था कि chlorophyll A जो है, chlorophyll A, that is a universal chlorophyll, और वो सब में found होती है. So along with that chlorophyll A, वो तो होना ही होना है. Plus इसके साथ chlorophyll B भी present है. ठीक है? You can write chlorophyll A along with chlorophyll B. Okay, these are the types of the chlorophylls. Right? Five types of chlorophylls are there. Chlorophyll A along with chlorophyll B. Right? These are the most common members of the algae, green algae, green plants, plants, plantae members mein sabse zyada commonly found jo class hai, that is of the chlorophyci members. Theek hai? Next is when these organisms they are to reproduce, that is if the lower organisms of this family of this class are there, they are reproducing through the spore formation asexually, and the higher through the gamete formation, that is inke andar aise members hote hain jaise wall box hai. Agar aap iska structure dekhenge, apni book mein given hogi uski photo, wall box mein kya hai, chote chote si colonies ban jati hain beech mein iske structure mein, theek hai. They are the kind of the gametes which will be undergoing the fusion and hence forming the new wall box. ठीक है, सो दैट इज अ काइंड ऑफ द ऑर्गेनिज्म. अगेन दीज आर शोइंग बोथ द मेथड्स ऑफ रिप्रोडक्शन. फॉर द लोअर ऑर्गेनिजम्स इट्स स्पोर फॉर्मेशन, एंड फॉर द हायर वंस दीज आर शोइंग द गेमेटिक फ्यूजन्स. ओके, दैट इज द मेथड ऑफ रिप्रोडक्शन. कमिंग टू द नेक्स्ट इज अ स्टोर्ड फूड इन इट. एज दीज आर द मोस्ट जनरल टाइप ऑफ द कैटेगरी ऑफ द प्लांट्स, सो द स्टोर्ड फूड इज ऑल्सो द जनरलाइज्ड वन, in which it is only storing the starch. Starch, in the form of the starch, the food is stored here in the members. As in general matlab jitne hamare plants, green plants hote hain, wo bhi yahi karte hain. The food stored is in the form of starch. Also the components of the cell wall, agar iski cell wall ki components ki baat kare to what it will be, what is the cell wall's component? What is the cell wall made up of? Cellulose. These are the most generalized ones. That is why the cell wall here is made up of the cellulose. Clear? Right? Jitne algae members aap padhenge, that is in the division thallophyta, jitne bhi algae members padhenge, may it be the chlorophyci, phaeophyci, rhodophyci, jo aage do classes karwani hai. For all the thallophytes, algae members, inka habitat common share hota hai. That is, they may be found in fresh water, may be found in brackish water, may be found in the salty water. ठीक है, so a common general habitat लिख लो सभी का. बाकी vary करता है कि कुछ एक species जैसे Phaeophyci है, उसमें fresh water में कम मिलते हैं organism, पर बाकियों में ज्यादा मिलते हैं, पर मिलते हैं. ठीक है, so we can count this as a habitat for all. So that is they may be present in the fresh water. First of all, fresh water organisms they are, brackish water or salty water. Salty water, brackish water is a kind of the marine water, like fresh water jaise hota na, that is not having any salt content in it. ठीक है, सॉल्टी इज विद द एक्सट्रीम सॉल्टी कंडीशंस. right, having higher conditions of the salty water. But the marine, when there we say that it is not purely fresh and not also the salty, extreme salty, then it is brackish water. Okay. Hanji, clear? So this is the component of the cell wall, that is, it is all made up of the cellulose. Stored food is in the form of the starch, and the pigments are simple again, that are the chlorophyll A and chlorophyll B, right? Now about the motile spores, jo aap logon ne padhe gametes ya spores jo bhi motile hote hain, so that is due to the presence of the motileness of the gamete or a spore, that is because of the presence of the flagella, hai na? Flagella ki wajah se ye motile hote hain, move kar sakte hain from here to there, and that flagella count varies from 2 to 8 for these members. Okay, write down flagella count that varies for these members, that may be 2 to 8 in number, 2 se 8 number mein ho sakte hain, plus inki jo length hoti hai wo equal hoti hai, they are equal in their lengths. Flagella 2 honge, 3 honge, 4 honge, jitne bhi honge, they are all equal in length, and also their arrangement is at the apex, so that is at the tip, apical, right? The motile spores, they are because of, or the gametes are because of the flagella. That flagella, flagella yahan pe likho, flagella is a feature which can be varying in their numbers with organisms, that can also have equal length, and also they are all arranged to the tip, apex. Jaise kal maine yahan pe Chlamydomonas banaya tha, you remember Chlamydomonas, jisme se aise do flagella nikale the, hai na? To wo Chlamydomonas mein uske tip pe present hai, apex pe, theek hai, having two flagella, it's a member of this family, this class, Chlorophyce, theek hai, clear, right? So this is what, this is a Chlorophyce. Coming to the next, second class is Phaeophyce. Second class is Phaeophyce. Pheo here means brown, brown algae. This has been given a common name as brown algae. Phaeophyce, they are brown algae members. In pigments, along with chlorophyll A, this is going to have chlorophyll C, plus another enzyme that which gives it the brownish color, that is fucoxanthin. These are the rare members of the thallophyta division. Matlab less in number hai, rare nahi hai, but less in number hai. Kafi variety hai. Red wale to bilkul hi kam hai. Theek hai, they are still less than the Phaeophyce. Matlab most abundantly found in the thallophyta group mein agar hum baat karein, to that is class Chlorophyce. ठीक है, सेकेंड नंबर पे Phaeophyce, थर्ड नंबर पे Rhodophyce, ठीक है, अकॉर्डिंग टू द मेंबर्स काउंट, राइट? सो पिगमेंट वाइज इट हैज ए तो यूनिवर्सल है, सब में प्रेजेंट होगा, सी एंड फ्यूकोजेथिन अलोंग विद, हैबिटेट शेयरिंग सेम, बट हियर द फ्रेश वाटर मेंबर्स आर अ बिट लेस, दैट इज देयर अ फ्यू स्पीशीज दैट विच कैन बी फाउंड इन द फ्रेश वाटर रिसोर्स, ओके, फ्रेश वाटर हैबिटेट, राइट? Coming to the stored food in this, that is in the form of another stored food form, that is called as laminarin. Laminarin, or in the form of mannitol. Right? The cell wall along with cellulose, because that is a basic component of the cell wall, cellulose to hona hi hona hai. पर Phaeophyce ब्राउन एल्गी में सेल वॉल के साथ एल्जिन भी प्रेजेंट होता है. दिस इज अनदर कंपोनेंट व्हिच इज फाउंड इन द सेल वॉल, फॉर्मिंग अ डिफरेंट टाइप ऑफ द स्ट्रक्चर. दैट इज व्हाई अभी आप देख रहे हैं कि इसमें हर जगह पे हमने इसके करेक्टर्स जो है वो डिफरेंट लिखे. अभी पहले तीन लिख ली है, तीनों डिफरेंट है, एक हैबिटेट को छोड़ दे, है ना? बाकी इतने सारे डिफरेंसेज और इतने बड़े बड़े मेन डिफरेंसेज आ रहे हैं, इसलिए इस क्लास को डिफरेंट बनाना पड़ा, है ना? जब हमने क्लासिफिकेशन किया था तब हमने यही बात करी थी ना, व्हेन द डिफरेंस इज अ लॉट, तो उसके लिए एक अलग ग्रुप बना दिया जाता है। पर डिफरेंस अगर बिल्कुल माइन्यूट हो, यानी ये सारी चीजें सेम होती, माइन्यूटनेस क्या होती है कि सिर्फ फ्रेश वाटर में रेयर स्पीशीज हैं, तो हो सकता है हम क्लास की सब क्लास बना देते, है ना। बट दीज आर प्रोवाइडेड विद ऑल द डिफरेंट कैरेक्टर्स, सो दैट इज व्हाई दीज हैव बीन प्रोवाइडेड अ सेपरेट क्लास एंड अ सेपरेट नेम। ठीक है, तो दिस इज क्लासिफिकेशन, राइट। कमिंग टू द फ्लैजेला काउंट, दे कैन बी टू इन नंबर इफ प्रेजेंट, दे आर नॉट वेयरिंग, दे आर टू इन नंबर बट अनइक्वल इन लेंथ। टू इन नंबर अनइक्वल इन लेंथ एंड देयर पोजिशन इज नॉट एपिकल, दैट इज लेटरल। यू कैन बी आस्क द डिफरेंसेज ऑल्सो, ओके। ये डिफरेंशिएट में भी आ सकते हैं, क्योंकि ये सारे पॉइंट्स हमने आपको यहीं पे, मैंने इसीलिए रेज करके दिए हैं ताकि आपको पता लगे कि दीज आर ऑल डिफरेंट। वॉट इज सेम, दैट इज सेलुलोज अभी तक सेम रहा है, क्लोरोफिल ए सेम रहा है, टू नंबर सेम रहा है बस। ठीक है, क्लोरोफिल ए तो है ही सबका जनरल फीचर है, सब प्लांट्स का। सेलुलोज है ही सबका जनरल फीचर है, सिर्फ एक यही एक कॉमन चीज है, वो भी उन स्पीशीज के साथ जहां पे क्लोरोफाइसी में टू फ्लैजेला प्रेजेंट होंगे, सिर्फ उनके साथ। अदरवाइज द नंबर वेरीज इन क्लोरोफाइसी, बट हेयर इन थियोफाइसी इट इज ओनली टू, राइट, क्लियर। हेयर इन दिस ग्रुप ऑफ थियोफाइसी देयर इज वन एग्जाम्पल ऑफ डिक्टियोटा, एग्जाम्पल लिखो इसमें, डिक्टियोटा इज देयर। बाकी जो कलम ने किए थे लेमिनेरिया एंड सार्गासम, जो फूड की तरह कंज्यूम किया जाता है जिनको, सो दे आर ऑल्सो द एग्जाम्पल ऑफ दिस क्लास। डिक्टियोटा, लेमिनेरिया, सार्गासम, दीज आर ऑल द मेंबर्स ऑफ द थियोफाइसी। नाउ इफ वी लुक ऑन टू द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ द थियोफाइसी मेंबर्स, दे डू हैव अ स्पेशल टाइप ऑफ अ स्ट्रक्चर इन विच दे हैव एक्सपेंडेड पार्ट, बट देयर इज अ बेस विच अटैचेस इटसेल्फ टू द सबस्ट्रेटम। ठीक है, एक बेस है, फिर बेस के ऊपर एक इस तरह से स्टॉक लाइक स्ट्रक्चर है, ये सारा थैलस है। ठीक है, इसको अब आपने कंफ्यूज नहीं करना कि ये रूट है या ये स्टेम है या फिर उसके ऊपर लीफ है, इसके साथ कंफ्यूज नहीं करना। बट इनका स्ट्रक्चर थैलस का इस तरह से बना हुआ है कि इसके नीचे रूट के जैसा बेस बना है, फिर स्टॉक स्टेम के जैसा स्टॉक बना है, that is called as type, and then above it there is a इस तरह से frond, thallus, irregular। ये flat है लेकिन इसका substratum के साथ जैसे attachment है ना, यहां से attached है, बाकी ये free moving है, पानी में है, बाकी ये free moving है, type है, frond है, लेकिन नीचे hold fast से ये जुड़ा हुआ है substratum के साथ। ठीक है, so you can label the parts of this, these are hold fast, that is one term, okay, hold fast, then the stalk like is called as stipe, and this thallus, that is an expanded part, that is called as frond, that is termed as frond, F-R-O-N-D, frond, okay, clear to all? What are the three parts? That is frond, stipe, and hold fast. I write the spellings again. It is frond, stipe, and hold fast. Hold fast. Okay, these are the three parts. Means the thallus of these members that shows a special type of the differentiations into the parts. ठीक है, otherwise हमने क्या कहा था, it is thallus, thallus है without root stem and leaf, this is also without root stem and leaf, है ना, but that was मतलब single simple, वो इस तरह से पूरा substratum के ऊपर attached था, मतलब जितना surface area था उतना पूरा attached था, है ना, पर यहाँ पे क्या है, this is having the particular उसमें differentiated सा structure बन गया। ठीक है, that is the structure specially shown by the dictyota member, dictyota ऐसा नजर आता है। ठीक है, हाँ जी, क्लियर। सो दिस वॉज द सेकेंड क्लास ऑफ द डिविजन थैलोफाइटा, दैट इज थियोफाइसी, रिटन, हाँ जी, डन। Next is, after this, there is the third class, that is the class Rhodophycina. This is Rhodophyceae. Rhodophyceae members, they do not have this kind of the fronded structure. These are called as red algae because of a special pigment that is phycoerythrin. Biome erythrin term jahan pe bhi milegi, that always means red, that represents red coloration. Okay, so this is here the pigments will be ek to A ke saath D hoga, not C. Along with chlorophyll A, there is chlorophyll D, not C. Okay, and a special pigment that is phycoerythrin. Phycoerythrin is a special pigment that which provides red coloration to the members. नहीं, ये specially phycoerythrin उसी categories में से कहीं से लिए गए, ठीक है? They are the generalized pigments के नाम जो मैंने general बोले थे ना, तो उन्हीं में से आगे categories बहुत सारी हैं. Then is the stored food. Here the food store is in the form of the Floridian starch, that is some kind of a modified starch. It is Floridian starch. And the cell wall along with the cellulose is made up of pectin. In this class of Rhodophyceae, the flagella are absent. These are not present at all. So they are absent. Right? Coming to the examples. कल हमने दो examples पढ़ी थी. Agar जहां से मिलता है. What were those? याद करो उन बच्चों उन नामों को. Gelidia man, Gracilaria. जहां से agar मिलता है. So they are the members of Rhodophyceae. So this is Gelidium and Gracilaria. They are the members of Rhodophyceae. Even in biological classification chapter, I remember you people have studied for the red tides, red pigment. वहां पे भी आपने पढ़ा था ना, वो भी ऐसा ही member था जी वाला, ठीक है? आपको पढ़ाया मैंने, हाँ, Goniolex, हाँ, आपको पढ़ाया वहां पे भी, है ना? So that is again a significant, you can say एक ट्रेंड होता है, ठीक है? पूरे जो हम लोग नेमिंग्स करते हैं ना, तो उस हिसाब से एक ट्रेंड के हिसाब से नेमिंग्स होती है कि हमने नाम देने हैं तो किस तरीके से हमें इजीली याद रहे, कहाँ पे वो स्ट्राइक करें, तो एकदम से वहां पे स्ट्राइक किया करो, वहीं पे याद किया करो. जैसे अभी मैंने इसको रिकॉल किया, that is the red pigment was generated over there also because of the red pigment it was leading to the red tides, hai na? So you can also correlate it in this manner, right? Because all the things are similar. Bio mein maximum kya hota hai, ek cheez ek naam diya hai, waisa hi kahin aur bhi naam mein use aayega, waisa hi similar milta milta kahin aur use aayega. So when you are just reading it and you correlate it with your previous knowledge, then your concepts will be more clear. Okay, always correlate it. अब यहां से इसको याद रखना कि ये दो मेंबर्स थे जो कि एल्गी को बिलोंग करते थे, है रेड है, पर वो वाला जी वाला मेंबर, जैसे आपने भी बोला जी से था, है ना? तो ये जी वाले भी याद करने पड़ेंगे, ठीक है? अब कंफ्यूजन हो गया, गलत हो गया, एक आपको मैंने एग्जांपल में दे दिए ये दोनों के नाम, तीसरा गोनियोलेक्स एमसीक्यू में दे दिया, आप गोनियोलेक्स कर दोगे तो क्या होगा, गलत, ठीक है? ऑलवेज कोरिलेट द थिंग्स साइड बाय साइड, राइट? क्लियर? So this was the okay done. So this was the Rhodophyceae members, that is the red pigment, red algae members. Because of their red pigment, they appear to be red in coloration, right? हाँ जी. Habitat same है. इसमें I guess जो rarity है, that is in here brackish water. ठीक है. Less of the species are found in the brackish as well as in salty water. More are found in fresh water, I think. बाकी we can confirm it from the book as well, right? Habitat is same, that is shared by all the groups. Okay. Hanji, so this is over. Finally, this division of Thallophyta is done. Any questions to anyone? Anybody having any doubt? Now the next is the second division, Bryophyta. But before starting that Bryophyta, I have a small video for you people. I can show you that. You have to wait for it. Just a minute.
Which includes all plants that are multicellular, autotrophic eukaryotes. Plants are also found in various habitats, such as freshwater, seawater, deserts, tropical regions, etc. Plant cells have a cell wall, which is made up of carbohydrate cellulose and stores food in the form of starch. The cell wall gives framework and mechanical strength to plant cells. Most of the plant cells contain a green-colored pigment, chlorophyll, present in the chloroplast, which is why they are photosynthetic. A few flowering plants are heterotrophic. Some live in a symbiotic relationship with bacteria. Some plants are insectivorous. For example, the Venus flytrap traps insects and digests them and gains its nutrients. While some plants, like the scuta, are parasitic, that is, they live on other plants for their nutrients. Plants are immobile and do not exhibit locomotion as seen in protists or other animals. Some plants show sexual mode of reproduction, while some show an asexual mode of reproduction. Plant life cycles have two alternating phases, a haploid phase and a diploid phase. The diploid phase is called the sporophyte and produces spores, while the haploid cell is called a gametophyte and produces gametes. Kingdom planting is mainly divided into five phyla. Bryophyta, Lycopodophyta, Filicinophyta, Coniferophyta, and Angiospermophyta.
Students, please listen. Here the names are differently given, right? Because these are the phyla, right? They have provided something like division से ऊपर एक groups बना दिए उन्होंने, तो उस accordingly उन्होंने names दिए हैं, and these are purely the botanical names or the biological जो हम लोग plant में use करते हैं, ठीक है? So but here in your classification, as up to your level, this is only Thallophyta, Bryophyta. Don't confuse it, right? It is Bryophyta. Second Lycopodophyta जो इसने बोला है, that is the Thallophyta. That is third वाला जो इसने आगे बोला है, that is the ferns जो नीचे picture है. Then there is Coniferophyta, jo bola hai, that is gymnosperm, and Angiospermophyta. Hanji, I'll play this again for you, right? From here only, from where we exited.
Bryophytes are green plants in which the gametophyte is the dominant generation. They lack the water conducting and food conducting vessels, xylem and phloem respectively. Most bryophytes grow on land, but they are largely restricted to damp environments. They do not have true roots, but they are anchored with the help of rhizoids. Liverworts, mosses are the examples of bryophyta. Lycopodophytes are plants with extremely small, spirally arranged leaves. A good example of the same is crab moss. Ferns are filicinophytes. Their leaves are tightly coiled and uncoiled in their early growth and development. On the lower surface of their leaves are clusters called sori. These sori contain the sporangia required for reproduction. Coniferophytes are cone-bearing plants with both male and female cones, often on the same plant. Their leaves are usually waxy and needle-shaped. Example, pine tree and cycas, etc. The last phylum of kingdom plantae is Angiospermophyta, which is a dominant group of land plants. They are seed-bearing plants. The seeds are enclosed in a fruit formed from the ovary. Flowers are unique to the angiosperms. The development of flowers has been associated with the evolution of complex mechanisms for pollen transfer and seed dispersal. Angiosperms has two groups, monocots and dicots. Monocots have only one seed leaf inside the seed coat, while dicots have two seed leaves inside the seed coat. The leaves of monocots are often long and narrow, with their veins in straight lines.
Rest, these are the features of the differences between the monocots and the dicots. That is veins, they are having the parallel venation and everything that we have already studied. So, coming to the next. Anji, beta, just wait a minute.